Let's continue with the first look, review and revisiting series. This time we will tackle a quite interesting game called The 7 Years War. It is a grand strategy game involving a strategic map, but also a tactical layer with battles, so it's in a similar fashion like Total War. And I've discovered this game, I don't know, a day ago. And yeah, it covers the 7 Years War, which I think was caused because the French and the British disputed over territories in North America. You know, back then the US didn't exist as states. And I think even George Washington participated on the British side in some of the battles. And this border dispute evolved into a complete global war. So despite World War I and II being named like that, there was some world wars before that, and this also was definitely a global war. You can read on it on the internet, and if you take a look at the participants, it involved basically all major powers and a lot of continents. I don't know, I think 5 continents saw combat. And yeah, it's currently also on heavy sale. Sure, the reviews are mixed again. And yeah, I already told you that I think user reviews are a really good thing. But especially for complex niche games, always check them for yourself, double check them. Because there are people, I don't know, manage to buy games, don't look at the screenshots, and then they are surprised when they are not encounter high-end graphics. I mean, if you take a look at it, yeah, I mean, reviews like this, the $2 was too much for this hearts. What the F, looks like 1983 games, so ugly and well, just horrible, unhearting, believable, that same on release, same trash, like this, shame. Yeah, negative review, I mean, no comment. But I've skimmed some of the reviews, and it looks like, and extracted some of the essence, intelligent essence. And what is troubling, that some people mention that, what is troubling, issues that issues that are valid criticism I've read was that this game lacks a good tutorial to introduce you into the game and the game mechanics. Some also mentioned that some mechanics, like, I don't know, trade or the logistics, might have issues. It's, of course, it's difficult to say if this is because the individual didn't understand how to use it. You know, as you sometimes also have this phenomenon that, I don't know, people don't grasp a gameplay mechanic, and they think it's a fault of the game, or if it's valid. But that's what I extracted from it, especially the lack of a tutorial. I myself need to get a grasp of this game, so this is definitely a raw first look. I already checked out the interface and everything, and it's definitely not a game I can go into and immediately play because it's self-explanatory. However, if you're interested in this and looking for documentation for that, it's definitely a manual lying in your game directory when you install it. And I skimmed through it, looks it isn't that big. It looks quite a lot of screenshots. Didn't read it yet, but looks like you can work with it. You know, explain. This here is production chains. It has a system similar to games like Anno. You know, this economy management game. There, where you need to raw materials or resources, which are then produced to something else. At least on the first glance, it looks like this. Yeah, we'll skim through it. You can pause the video if you want to look at the specific page. But it looks, on the first glance, that I can work with it. Weather and temperature DLC. I'm more interested into the campaign. There are DLCs I will show you in a moment. I think the interface also makes a good impression. Even have tips playing the campaign. I like it if the devs put also some effort into this. And yeah, let's return to the store page. I currently got the main game, but there are some DLCs, Battle Pack. And if you want to play the suites in the campaign, you have to get this. And it gives you the ability to do so, coming with their own special stuff and music and historic events for Sweden. The other one, I think, a battle pack, was also, I guess, historical battles. You know, similar to similar to Total War. You have the campaign layer, but you can also access historical battles to play them. Looks like, so it comes with a custom battle generator and weather. Not sure if some of these features are represented in the campaign. So I'm mainly interested in the campaign, so I didn't get the DLCs yet. And yeah, there's also a you know, if you go in the community hub of a Steam game, perhaps this game is also available somewhere else. Not sure, I found it on Steam. There's a guide section. And also here you have a guide for the battles and for the campaign gameplay, which could also be a good source for information if you're looking into it. You know, you only have to look. Some people are always so lazy, got them. You need hand-holding for everything. Sure, there are games, and it would be really great if all games would have a sophisticated tutorial, you know, that you... I also would like to start a game, and there's something like... I've recently made a review about King of the Dragon Pass. There's this step-by-step tutorial, which basically is built into the start of the game, and without it I would be lost in with the game, because it has this you know, this fantasy aspects like magic, and somehow they can be abstract, and definitely helps to introduce you in the game in an easy fashion. I also found two videos. I didn't watch them yet, but I can imagine I will do, and they might be quite helpful before I start to seriously play this. By History Guy Gaming, and there's part one, which is, I guess, focusing on the campaign layer, and there's part two, which is focusing on the combat, so the two major aspects of this game. And yeah, it's a 7 years war, like I said, global war, all major powers involved. it's not the 30 Years' War, whatever. Sometimes you can mix up the titles of this historical or historical wars. And I wanted to include it in this period, this era, you know, of warfare. If you are interested into it, but you think, God damn it, there are no games, you might also take a look at some of the Total War mods. I personally, my personal favorite is Medieval 2 Total War. I mean, sure, there is after that Empires and Napoleon, which would translate better to this era of warfare, you know, the pike and shot warfare and first guns appearing on the battlefield. But yeah, I'm a big fan of Medieval 2, and there was also this 30 years mod I've shown. However, check it out for yourself. This is the Total War Center forums, and every of the games have this hosted modification. For Medieval 2, the most sophisticated modifications you will find for Kingdoms, which was basically the expansion which was released to Medieval 2 and makes it the most sophisticated platform for mods. And you can check it out. There are so many mods about wars you never heard of, or about wars that aren't that often displayed in games. And there's the 30 years, I think I made a video about it, I really liked it. You know, it was a really brutal war in Europe, caused by religious disagreements, but then really become extremely bloody conflict, costing a lot of lives. And yeah, you have to check it out also yourself. Sometimes you can't judge by the title which war is simulated or whatever. And also check out the other games like Empires or whatever. But for me, really, Medieval 2 Total War was the last. I don't know why. I guess I also have some, because I've played the heck out of it. And I remember Empires, yeah, Lithuanian faction. Okay. And with Empires, it was a bit going down, you know, the Total War hype for me. Okay. So let's return to the Seven Years War. And I think it's time to check out the game. We talked about the manual. And yeah, currently $2. I mean, sometimes it's really, you have a bad feeling that you get games, I mean, like this, complete experience like this for so little money. Okay. Yeah, Windows 10, it starts without problems. I mean, I always run Windows 10, I don't run Windows 95 or whatever, and great menu music. Good track. Like it. A lot of options, I like it. Number of trees, vegetation, battle unit updates. Is this, yeah, battle unit size, let's go full force. Battle unit updates. Does it mean animation updates? So hover, tooltip. Enlighten menus. Keep it on default. Battle unit updates. Battle unit updates. Could imagine that this is basically how often animations are. You know, in games like Total War, if you zoom out, or if it becomes really. Or in games like Scourge of War, also a great game. You sometimes see that the animations are skipped in order to ease the load on the PC. I will keep it this way and we'll see if changing something will, perhaps we can change it in game. Languages, perhaps some interesting for you. You have Espanol, Deutsch, Francais and English. order delays. I like it. I can imagine what this is. That your orders aren't translated instantly. Score speed, score whatever, weekly, yes. Battle time limit. So you have similar options like in Total War. Historical features only. What does this mean? I mean, historical is always good. I can't tell what this means. We would have a look at, I guess the manual explains it. Yeah, aggressive is normal. And first we will take a look at the campaign. However, I can't tell much of it. I can't explain much of it. So it might be a short trip, because it doesn't make that much sense. I can try to figure out stuff on my own, but yeah, you have the links for the DLCs with a short information what it gives you. So let's check the campaign. Yeah, similar screen like in Total War. So that's the major players, Britain, France, everybody coming with their own tunes, Austria, Preußen, and Russia. And for Swedish campaign, we need to get the DLC. And yeah, you see, that's the map. We have Europe and we have Northern America. And you see there is French territories and this is our British territories. And that's what caused this war. There were some regions both tried to get for themselves, and it ended in open conflict. Diplomatic means failed, and somehow then this war exploded into a global war. Complete 30 tutorial steps. Hey, this sounds good. Is there a tutorial in this game? Let's play the British, because complete 30 tutorial steps sounds for me good. Tutorial. The Road to War. So the British is a tutorial. Yeah, you see, that's something. I mean, first check it out, but this Steam reviews, they are sometimes so goddamn misleading. You check it out, you think, and some people mention there is no tutorial. I have no idea. I mean, it's hidden, I must say. If, for example, if you get this game and want to play French from the beginning, you might not notice that there's tutorial written. But first check it out, I see what this tutorial is about. I think it would be better to highlight it that the British, if this is the case, if the British campaign is some sort of tutorial, to highlight it better. Because there's only this little line mentioning it. The tutorial, the manual perhaps us as well. Yeah, and that's a map. Sure, it's not having the extreme graphic fidelity like, I don't know, what a Total War, modern Total War, but I think still it's fine. And you can also try to do some reshading or whatever. I always use reshades. I think it reminds me a bit like a Mountain Blade. Okay, so where's this tutorial? Holy shit, we are losing money. So let's pause. City overview, army and fleet overview, goods overview, politics, diplomacy, research, build, financials, scenario goals, tutorial. As your first scenario. Okay, sounds fine. Do I need to select it? Will it trigger? Okay, first check out the UI. I like it. You always have. I think this should be in. Yeah, good morning, chill stream. How are you? I think that's the golden standard. Always give a tooltip or whatever, because otherwise I couldn't tell what these buttons are. And yeah, let's check out this, the okay menu and options. Let's begin from the left to the right, and then we will work in a clockwise fashion. So this is goods and production. We already take a peek at it, it's, yeah, we have, I guess, import, export. I mean, in the beginning it's a bit overwhelming. What is this, the prices? Yeah, that's our settlements, I guess. I guess tells you what is the price currently there, what is the import, what's the export, and 5, whatever, we will figure it out. Army, supply, fleet. So I guess supply is important. It always was an important part of warfare. Especially back then when you were a big colonial superpower. So that's next is production. Small farm at Georgia. Producing horses. Yeah, currently I can't tell, but we will see. I hope this tutorial will guide us. We already checked out this button. You have time controls here. Can you also space? No, okay, there must be another hotkey. Then we have city overview. That's basically our settlements. You can, I guess, if you click them, they will your game. There has some Total War style, but I could imagine this is somewhere more realistic in some terms than Total War, you know, especially. Increase the tax rate. You have some AI support, looks like. Automatic tax adjustment. So you can give some of your, if you don't want to micromanage everything. Buildings, upgrading, destroying them. I mean, it really looks on the first glance, it looks like a really sophisticated game. Look at this. Good UI information. You can spend some time on it if you want to check out. You have the really like it. Information. What is causing what? A lot of stuff has tooltips. I'm somewhat surprised to see the a lot of modern technical functions. Army fleet overview. Yeah, we have some dudes with fancy hair. First division east of England. It's him. 10,000 men. Build. Okay, no, I guess that's not not from this buttons don't belong to the army. Here are the orders. Fast match. Engage supply trains. Retreat. Maneuver. Engage traders, so you have different settings. This tells you where they are currently sitting. Yeah, I like this. That's basically a division editor. I guess this translates into the tactical battles. And might make a difference. For example, you want, I don't know, the calf having in a separate brigade, you could do so. I mean, it even makes sense. Why is this 9th Army, 8th Dragoons, 7th Lancer? But we will leave it, keep it this way, and there must be a reason why it is so. But you could also do and separate the calf. Perhaps it, we don't have now currently information about the tactical battles, so don't change anything without knowing what's going on. But you see this, and what is this? Move unit to create division. Disperse unit. Unit name, can get your own name into the game. Can replace the commander. What? Some more information about them. I really like roleplay elements in games like this. Medieval 2 got it really good. I mean, they have stars. Do they have, I don't know, abilities like, I don't know, drunkard. Stuff like this, you know, from Total War. I always like this from Medieval. This character traits they had. Okay, but I guess also these guys are historical persons. Weapon class, artillery. Navy Commanders. Guess these are some sort of filters. That's, yeah, amateurs talk about tactics, but professional study and logistics, exactly. Logistics played a major role in almost every war. And especially back then, for example, I think France followed the tactics almost never to send troops to their colonies, but because it was, they simply couldn't bring up the logistics because the British Navy was so dominant. And they simply used the tactics to let the local government, local militia, whatever, fight for themselves and try to maintain a dominant position at Europe, gain some territory here, and then exchange it for possible losses in the colonies. Didn't work out, from what I know. But also because they couldn't bring up the logistics, they couldn't transport troops, couldn't supply them because the sea was dominated by enemy powers. Okay, yeah, we were this button, I've now checked the build button. Here you can create buildings, and it looks like you can create the buildings also on the map. So it really has a big emphasis on economy. Next is financials. Yeah, you have some options to generate money or to work with debt. Offices we already checked out. Nations comparison. I mean, really like the UI. Information is provided. What is this? Yeah, that's a population. Satisfaction. Looks like the people in Great Britain aren't that happy yet. What is this? Unemployment. Is green good? Or is it bad? I mean, normally I would guess red is bad. 72%, does it mean they're employed, or 72% unemployed would be a bit, but 30% employed, I mean, can this be, it would be crazy, but I don't know, back in the days, you know, when there was some major financial or whatever crash, perhaps it was possible that, I don't know, 2/3 of the people didn't have jobs or whatever. Income level, I mean, we are one of the highest. But yeah, nobody would think that because we are ranked so low, this would mean that we are doing bad, so our unemployment isn't good. Otherwise, this would be a bit misleading. Productivity, research. Ah, we have some buttons here. Treasury, yeah, Great Britain, what the hell, nobody's working, but the kings and whatever, the noble are hoarding money, business as usual. Trade income, yeah, sure, we are also making good trade income as one of the major naval powers and colonial powers. Army, France is quite a big army, but I think naval power is ours, yeah, you see, and that was the different focuses, as of course because of logistical challenges. France had a really powerful land army at Europe especially, but they couldn't compete with the fleet of the Britain of Great Britain, and couldn't put more troops or limited, we are limited in the ability to bring reinforcements and supplies into their colonies. And you can have the biggest army in the world, but if you can't cross the sea, so it's limited to Europe. And that's why they committed this strategy to this exchange philosophy of, but it didn't work out from what. Okay, let's check out the politics screen. No policy chosen. You can have multiple UIs element open. I like it. Yeah, before we press it, I don't want to press it. But okay, we might check it out. So I guess this is some sort of active policy which gives you an effect. And I guess you are limited. If you choose one right now, yeah, perhaps we are limited for some years using this in order to prevent that, you know, you change it on a daily basis in order to simulate that if you enact a policy, it takes some time to become established, as it takes some time to get rid of it again. Before we will choose it, we will look at the other screens. Yeah, let's see, diplomacy, France. Okay. Give me all of you. All of your base belong to me. Declare war. Okay, these are the buttons. Can also trade technologies. Can exchange prisoners and payments. This is the offer button, so it's also a demand button. Give me. Aliens needed. Okay, what happens if I press weapons? Yeah, we will figure out in time. We'll figure it out how this works. Not needed currently. Yeah, the world map. This button here is, I guess, filters. Yeah, I think this helps you to tell what territory is what. You know, back then, Central Europe had a lot of territories. And so even a bigger zoom out, but that's fine. I think you can also click on the map here to transition fast. And somewhere here, I think, I mean, all the yellow bars doesn't look good, and red symbols, I think they're somewhere they were clashing with each other. And this conflict, border conflict, caused this global war. You know, gentlemen agree to disagree, and then hundreds of thousands had to bite the dust. Okay, information. That's the tutorial, found it. Yeah, the tutorial is a bit hidden, but you know, again, that's why I like user reviews, but I think I read one, or I've read it on the forums, there's absolutely no tutorial. That's the big problem of this game. Yeah, we start the game and find a tutorial. I mean, sure, it's hidden. It's hidden if you don't start Britain and I don't activate this button. You might miss it. But here it is. Now you know. We will simply follow it. You see, even with interactive here, it's really not bad. Okay, game menu. Okay, that's a game menu. Now click on this text to continue. Which text? Oh, okay. Yeah, it's okay. It's a bit... You need to figure it out. It's also a tutorial in figuring stuff out. So you need to... Okay, that's the status bar. Date, money, earnings. Okay, good to know. Speed of the game. Orders can be still given when the game is paused. That's also good. Good productions. Production buildings, cities, military. Pause the game to continue. It's really well made. mean, not bad. Okay, that's city overview like in Total War or in other games. Capital. Let's zoom in. Yeah, these are the provincial buildings, production buildings and whatever, trade buildings. Directly on the terrain, current production, you can see in the symbol, and if you hover over it, quarterly earnings, supply stock red, okay, and production green. So they have free, I don't know, wheat and producing grain, free wheat, free grain. One is brighter green than the other, sure why, but workforce shown on the right, utilization and workforce are shown on the right. This here, this symbol. Now click the small map to scroll directly to North America. Native settlements, okay, so Native Americans represented. Range, strength, which one is which, but I guess the red one is range, yellow is strength, and the relationship. So if there is a red symbol, I think they might be not our best friends. Can't tell. Relation horses. Yeah, Great Britain, zero. So I guess this means we are yeah, definitely, it's not the most, but still, at least there is a tutorial. I mean, for me, this is still a game changer. I think if you go through it, if you manage, then you can understand the game without leaving the screen. But there were reviews or whatever form mentioning no tutorial in place whatsoever, which is not correct. Okay, these are trading places, and now we want to change to trading activities. Now change the priority bars for trading activities on one trading place to continue. Okay, yeah, that's this this little icons here, which so it's basically a priority. So this is now prioritized in favor. Favor of this. Here I'm looking for a place. It's resources, I guess red means. Does mean red? It's basically our nation's color. Does red mean not good, no good placement because of lack of resources? Small mine. They checked the Americas again. Perhaps they wanted us to build it here somewhere. Loam, coal or iron ore. Be sure that the bottom of the resource on the map is highlighted, which indicates that this resource is in the range of the building. Guess he means this here, that it comes green. I mean, but there is already a small mine, that doesn't make sense. Let's build a mine for the king. Can we build two mines on a location? Makes the sense to extract even more. What is this here? Iron ore! I think this is open. Ah, I guess you see there's some. If you move away. Okay, but somehow we can't build it here. What's the problem? Is it a. It's the region too, the terrain too complicated or what? So, is it already mined by this guy here? Yeah, I mean the tutorial could be really a bit more informative, but we'll figure it out. We have iron. Ah, this will work, I see. Yeah, it's really hard to see, but you see something happening here. Could be, of course, here as well. So I might not want to put it right on the border, to the French border, otherwise we might build the mine for the French. So I think this here is good. Let's find the tile again. Here. Okay, company overview. Yeah, you can't click this here, it only gives you the do you want to cancel, but because the tutorial can't tell if it's building, but you want to click one of these buildings here and then you get this screen. It's really a mix of, I don't know, Anno and Total War. Perhaps that's on a first glance. Looks like there's a lot of effort put into the economy layer, business layer. Oh, okay, you can automate it. That's fine. I don't. I'm not a salesman. I want to wage. I don't know. If I'm too busy with global politics, please take. Yeah, let's automate it. Is it okay? If the button is pressed in, it's perhaps hard to tell on stream. But I think if it's pressed in, is it for every company? Okay, let's continue the tutorial first. Yeah, pre-gods like an anno. Produce bricks with the French. If we come with our troops, the French will produce bricks. You can count on it. Oh, holy shit, I didn't see this. Holy moly. Do I wish it? I don't know. But let's do it. Okay, let's get some timber. Timber is always good. Having some wood is always good. Quit the menu. Yeah, I wanted to see if is every company managed. Yeah, I think it's. No, wait, the button is pressed in. And that's not a company. That's also not a company. Let's find another company. It looked like it was. Let's depress it. See what happens to the others as well. No. Okay. Yeah, I will keep the pricing. But if you like, you know, micromanaging the economy, sure, why not? I like it. It's fresh. Never seen. You know, Anno. On the other hand, I've sometimes even missed it in Anno. Anno has pretty. I'm not sure about the new one. They released a new Anno, 1800 or whatever. But combat or warfare in Anno was always a pretty basic affair. And here you have a mix between, and I think, you know, why they waged combat over this, why they waged war about this areas, you can tell it was a lot about resources and trade. You know, the wars back then, especially this caused by this colonial stuff, there were a lot about this stuff, so it's, I think it's a good idea to give it a bigger emphasis. Okay, so similar, you need some sort of barracks or garrison or field camp, and then you can recruit. The higher the population, the more buildings can be constructed, and city buildings have pros and cons. Corruption -5, is this good? I guess so. Or is it bad? Sometimes hard to tell if -5 means minus corruption or. But I guess, official building. Is it good? Is it bad? Can't tell. Could cause both, yeah. Having an official building. But I guess it's removing it. Otherwise, the pros wouldn't be too little and nobody would build this building. No, construct any building to continue. Let's construct a statue. No. Create building. Doctor's house. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, having some public healthcare is never wrong. 5 timber. 700 gold. Yeah, we are rich. We are completely rich. Take it. Move to the right floor. There's a big pile of gold. Take something of it, how much you need, and have fun. Okay, we constructed this, and yeah, you have some overview statistics. I also like it. You can work with it. Religion. Most are, yeah, sure, it's especially in Britain. Most are Protestants. You know, after they had this breakdown with the, who was it who created his own church? You know, this guy who got a bit of trouble with the Pope. Okay. The influence of happiness. Yeah, similar to combat mission, you know, they use these icons. I think it's hard to tell, but you don't need to count it. So if you hover over it, you see buildings plus 12, tax minus 20. That's the satisfaction. And the tax is causing minus 20. Health minus 3, but we will build a doctor's house, so this will improve it. I forgot it. What was it? Plus 4 or something. And religion, because they have some religious confrontations between the Protestants and the Orthodox. No, Orthodox is nobody here. The Catholics, it's causing some stress. Building. Yeah, because we are building, I guess. People have to work, and you know, back in the days, working wasn't. You had what did you have? I don't know. Did you even have one day of holiday in the year? I don't think so. It's pretty crazy how the people survived back then. I remember reading an article about Siemens, you know, big German company. And there was a big announcement, you know, like they would announce, I don't know, the becoming the social big social Samaritas. And the article was work for, I don't know, something not in the exact wording, but work for Siemens, now you will receive one day of holiday in a year. It's unbelievable. I mean, back in the days, especially in the time of industrialization, and I can't imagine how people survived working under these conditions, even survived a week. Yeah, okay, that's fine. And you know, back in the days, there weren't safeties, and you didn't receive your loan on a monthly basis, but most times I think you received your loan on a daily basis. So if you were ill or didn't work, you didn't receive money, and some people had to work every day in order to somehow manage to supply themselves or their families. Okay, leave the menu. Financials. Laissez-faire capitalism is heartless. Yeah, definitely is. I guess industrialization, the time of industrialization, was really the absolute peak of fuck humans and give me maximum output. I mean, a lot of the stuff you know from today, you know, holidays and worker protection or working place protection or whatever, they weren't created because people were thinking, yeah, I mean, let's help the not, they weren't created because of human reasons or social reasons. They were created because people noticed, yeah, if you give them a bit holidays or give them some protection, they work even more efficient. But I think it's crazy. I remember when in school we were taught the stories about two families living in a what would be today a student or a single apartment. Back in the days, two eight-head families lived back in a building like this, and both had two different shifts and slept in the same bed with four or five persons in one bed. It's unbelievable how they, I mean, how they survived this without, I don't know, jumping out of the window after a week. Sure, they didn't grow old. A lot of them died in accidents or whatever, but it's crazy that humans could suffer through this. Yeah, okay, so coin debasements is basically stamping more money, which of course has a short-term effect. Long-term effect is of course the impact on inflation, the money getting less, having less value. But for short-term, sure, you have some more bucks in the pocket. This was often basically a desperate measure to have more money. But on a long-term, it often impacted the economy in a drastic negative way. Yeah, definitely. People fought and died for labor rights or for other human rights. It's sometimes really, if you think about it, that we really live in a, there's always room for improvement, but, and also depending on where you live, of course, but a lot of stuff we take for granted was established, was fought for by, I don't know, thousands and millions of people. If they weren't here, we would still live under some king's rule who would tell us, God declared me the king and you have to be my slave or whatever. Yeah, unbelievable that we got this game for two bucks. What can you get for $2 on a handy store? I don't know, Angry Birds. Sometimes you really, there's some really hidden games. Sure, we have to see it in a complete, it's too early for judgment, but I can already tell, at least I have a feeling for it, and I can tell it's not, I don't know, a 5-week project in Unity or whatever, but some effort was put into it. And from the name of the developer studio, it appears to me that this is a single person because it's named. I mean, let's take a look at it. Can I tap? Tap isn't working. Okay. Why this? Whatever. Oh shit. I think that was a bad idea to tap. Damn it. I hope I didn't crash the game. Yeah, and the death is Oliver Keppelmüller, and because it's an individual's name, I could extrapolate from it that it's a single individual who is making the game, but sure, can also be more people. I hope I can re-access the game. Ooh. Yeah, okay, at least we can, I hope we can save the tutorial. So tapping the game might be not the best idea. Let's see if there's a way to restore it. Sometimes the game needs an trigger to refresh. Because if you access the options menu, you change something on the graphics, it might, let's do this and see if what happens. No. And it has VR SD camera, really good. Yeah, it looks a lot of options are locked, so I think the graphics modes are locked. Now, sometimes you can fix it by changing graphics, because the game then reinstates the graphics and reloads the textures. But I think we might bug the game. I'm a bit afraid if I reload that the tutorial start from the beginning. I mean, normally you wouldn't alt-tab the game. Damn it. Yeah, okay, let's save. Otherwise it would might botch the video. This should work. Normally this tutorial is fine. Often the tutorials restart because they work after a script which isn't incorporated into your save. It's simply an basically on-screen prompt script which is executed. But looks like the tutorial is incorporated in the save, so good job on this. Otherwise it might botch my complete video. Because people would think, look, the game isn't working, but not many people are simply tapping out of games. However, I need a short break. I need to visit the restroom, and I might be back in 5 minutes. If you're on YouTube, simply skip it. And wait. First area bombing on U.S. soil was not Pearl Harbor, but when the government bombed striving miners demanding better work conditions at Blair Mountain. Yeah, this 1921, yeah, even before this, there were it's crazy what the nobility did in order to keep their what they called God granted right. It's unbelievable. I mean, the people really, you can't imagine this, the people back then. Sure, it depends, but a lot of the people back then, and especially in the Dark Age, in the Middle Ages, they believed that the life you're living currently is shit. It's made for being shit. And you have to be a good whatever Christ, a good whatever, a good subordinate, a good slave, and you will be granted a better life in eternity or in the you get it, depending on the religious belief. And it's simply unbelievable to leave, hard to grasp to leave, to live a life like this, that you basically have the belief that your life is struggle and absolutely not fun. And yeah, give me a moment, I will turn in some minutes. Okay. So let's continue with the tutorial. Next video is done. Yeah, about this topic, there are some interesting novels or books. There's a German book, I think it's quite popular, called Die Weber or Der Weberaufstand. I'm not sure how to translate Weber to English, you know, people who wove stuff. And it is, I think, a novel which is in the genre of naturalism, which means that it tries to depict the situation and the people in its in a realistic, extremely realistic manner. And it's simply shocking. They had to do their daily work or weekly work, and they went to their lords or whatever, and they were completely exploited by them. If they told, I give you only 10 mark or whatever currency they had back then, instead of 30 mark, there was no way to bargain with them, because otherwise you would have no money. And the people ate, I don't know, years old bread, cutting away the pieces that weren't good anymore, as you can imagine if a bread is years old. Unbelievable. So, UK. Guess this is the standing. So, with Hanover, we are allied. Let's contact them. Weaver, yeah. Weaver is the English word for Weber. And there was this Weaver uprising. I think somewhere on a German or in the Central European territory, Preussian territory, whatever, was back then. Currently, but it was also a brutal time for them, and they suffered extremely. And one day they had enough, as you can imagine, and started an uprising. Not because they were aggressive or wanted political demands, because they had to survive, so on. Therefore, place the flag on a nearby friendly or enemy terrain. Wait, I need to check the far right button, this here. Set new meeting point. I can't imagine what this is. Yeah, that's a great function, I guess. If you're allied with somebody and you're at war, we can use it. You can basically instruct the allied AI to bring his army to a location or to a region. You know, often in these games, I need to make the music a bit. Yeah, you know, often in these games you're allied with some AI faction, and I don't know, if Paradox Games or whatever, and you're waging a major war, you know, the war that will decide the fate of the universe, and these guys are, I don't know, walking somewhere in the forest of unimportance. So this might trigger the AI to come for you, for your place. I guess because we, yeah, let's, this, I guess we need to press this button, yeah. That's the first version, right? Somewhere here, yeah. Need to press the right directly on the soldier. Action radius, okay. If an enemy unit enters this range, battle will commence. If an enemy supply train or trader enters your radio, it will be intercepted. Strength 96, supply 96, strength 9000. I guess these are different branches. 9000 men, 1200 kev perhaps, 200. Yeah, this looks like a kev infantry, perhaps artillery. I could imagine. Can't tell, this wall is so little. Hierarchy, where was it? Here. We already checked it out. Right click on the campaign map. Yeah, business as usual. If you right click here, he will move into this direction. Hierarchy button. ...4,500 infantry. Yeah, I like the detail. This is a unit, line infantry, 1,500 men, good morale. You have stats and what weapon they are using. They are using muskets. And if another division is in range, you can use these buttons to transfer units. Yeah, this ship yesterday, sneaky ship of escaped our judgment. If your division is situated next to a city, you can switch units from if researched and in stock. So it looks like even weapons need to be in stock. I mean, we are nearby London. Can we do something? Yeah, but let's follow first the tutorial. I mean, we are not exactly in range, but okay. So if you want, I don't know, transfer garrison or even upgrade them, and there's some weapons or whatever in the stock of London, you bring your division there and they will be re-equipped. Next we will try to ship the division. That's good. I mean, that's important. Embark. Embark on ship. Okay. If there's no fleet, it was, I guess this is the fleet which might pick them up. And now we need to wait. Are they moving? Yeah, you see. Okay. Yeah, it's sprite based, but why not? It's similar to a Scourge of War. And can we change this option? I was looking for battle unit updates. Is this perhaps causing the... I can't tell. Let's leave it on default. I was thinking perhaps this is, has something to do with the animation. I forgot what was default. 2, right? Or 3. Yeah, the fleet is even coming. They're reacting to the order. Yeah, it takes some time. Let's speed it up. Yeah, you can see stuff moving on the map. Look, the cards, can you select them? You can select them, interesting. I like it, I like it. Really looks great if you have sprites moving over a 3D map. Never seen it in a similar fashion. I like it. I mean, not bad. Okay. Select the fleet. That's, and yeah, we will disembark them here. It's only for tutorial purposes. And right click. And they are disembarked. Okay, I get it. Fleet menu. Yeah, that's also important. I guess fleet warfare is abstracted. I'm not sure if there's a tactical layer. I don't think so. That's a fleet menu. commander ships, frigates, ship of the line. '65, '85 gets a caliber. Ammo is also a thing. I guess it's somewhere shown in this information bar. Every day on sea costs supplies. So you can't pull off a total war and move them over the complete world, single stack everything. You need to watch out for your supplies. And is sent back to the next harbor. I guess they will do it automatically. Would be great, otherwise if they end up on the sea without supplies. Send the fleet out, choose favorite harbor for it. Set harbor for supply. Is it already set? Small harbor here near London. At least he's moving there. Yeah, let's speed up the game. Is there plus minus? Is there some hotkeys for it? 2, 3, 4 now. At least VSD is working, WASD, that's good. But some hotkey options. Ah, here. What? I don't see a speed up hotkey, so it looks like we have to use the interface currently. And click the harbor. We are currently stuck here. He wants for me to pause. I did this and to click on the harbor. He didn't reach the harbor yet, right? Is he in the harbor? Ah, okay, he stopped for some reason. Okay, I think now he's in the harbor. Yeah, now it works. Yeah, it could be also the number of cannons, sure. Would make more sense. Okay, you can activate automatic repair if somebody enters, that's good. I like automatization. Can create new fleets if there are ships available. And you can press recruits to weapons at cost of happiness, so basically enlist them. The larger and poorer your population is, the more recruits are available. Yeah, a lot of people forked. I mean, back in the, I think in this time frame, no, there weren't many patriots, especially under the common boots on the grounds. They fought for in order to have a living. Yeah, now we're talking. Okay, it looks like we now will declare war. Yeah, why not? I mean, that's basically. So we aren't in state of war yet. It's basically a moment before the 7 years war broke out. That was not even asked, are you sure, but simply at war. Gentlemen, we are at war. Okay, so watch out if you hover over these buttons and otherwise you might end in a might cause a global war by accident. Okay, exit the game speed to be sure that your finances. My finance doesn't look really good. I mean, that's the change. That's our treasury. Be sure if you not print low moral. Why we are paying so much? Okay, let's re-embark. And we want to siege Lille. It's located and call in the allies. But first close the screen, because the screen is causing this flag. Not sure what this is. Ah, okay, Lille here. So we are allied with Hanover. Hanover, what are you thinking about? Can I click it here? No, it's red. I guess they are not at war with them. I don't see the French flag. No, wait, they are, it looks like they are at war with French, as French. Cost diplomacy points, perhaps they aren't simply, perhaps they're refusing to do it. As I think, you crazy bastard caused war and pulled us into it, what the hell, and now you're even demanding. Okay, let's the first division, not sure if they are enough, but embark them. Let's continue the game. Yeah, perhaps we can capture the harbor and block it. Like I mentioned, we have the upper hand when it comes to naval force. Who is this guy? A trading ship, great. There's also a road, I could imagine these roads make a movement faster. Okay, this will take some time. Do we have other fleet assets nearby? Something far away. There is. Let's block this. Can we block the French ports? Where is this guy moving? Did they deploy? Looks like they're landing currently. And is this our ship symbol or is this harbor ours? No, it's a ship symbol. Okay. We will block the channel. Ah, you can queue orders. Yeah, you know what? I think it doesn't look like that this is causing much. Simply block the channel. Somebody comes. Is this a French ship? This is a trading point, right? So this would perhaps also be a good idea. Do we have more fleet assets? Where was this fleet screen? Channel fleet, home fleet, okay, that's where's the home fleet? What is selected here? That's the home fleet. I guess the channel fleet is the second fleet we issued orders. Yeah, that's this one. And the third fleet is based on in North America. And we will leave them here to react to. It looks like they're trading heavy here. They have a lot of trading points here. Might intercept this. I mean, the middle eastern coast of North America is belonging to us, so they of course have the northern territory, so let's bring the fleet. We have, okay, 2 frigates, 4 corvettes isn't really the biggest fleet, but conquer trade fleets. It's a button you can press in. Attack war fleets. Avoid attacking strong fleets, definitely. And attack war fleets, okay. But don't attack. I hope these orders can be combined. Don't attack if they will blast you away, of course. And the same we will do for these guys here. Conquer trade points, whatever. Attack war fleets, avoid conquer. What's this button? And guys who block the channel, same. And now we can speed up. This guy will take some time. Let's check his situation. Guess this is supply. Yeah, it would be great to have an hover tooltip here. I don't want to do a fast march. I guess it comes with big disadvantages when it comes to morale and supplies. Plunder and looting, no, we are gentlemen. But you can engage traders. And supply trains. But I guess it will cause them to auto-move. Okay, that's fine. This harbor here, friends. So, who is this guy? Returning to Liverpool. Show me your ID. But yeah, that's fine. Let's speed up the game. It's the 2nd Shark Division of the French Navy. Where are the French Sharks? We prosecute them. Not sure. Do we want to bring forces to Brest? I mean, they still can. But we can't cover the complete French coast. Otherwise, we would have to split our navy and that's not what I want to go for. But I mean, you get an idea how to play this game. So, come on. Sure, it's a rough tutorial, but it's a tutorial and this guy's, I like the sprite. And they are moving fast. Oh, trading fleet captured. Hey, they captured something. Good job. You are allowed to pass. Pause the game. Siege of City. Also, you have this notification system. You click on it, you will be brought to the place of incident. Okay, we are at Lille. After you are firm with the siege functions. Wow. Okay, this looks quite interesting. So they're building times. Building a camp will take 1.3 days. Is this our buttons? Oh shit, yeah. And there is a garrison defending Lille of 1,500 men. They are also keen to fight. Defense fire on building troops. Fire suppression artillery ban. I guess these are some stances of your troops. We will leave it to default. And that's the status of the besieger. They have supplies for a trillion of years. Ah, wait, is it 2.8 days? I was thinking it's 2,800 days. You can't tell me that it can't be that much. It would be too crazy. Hey, look in the cellar. Bring, please, the supplies for the next, I don't know, what, 10 years, 9, 8, 7 years. So I guess this is... This is 2.8 days. Looks like the siege is quite sophisticated. Is that some... We build more stuff because it was mentioning that we can build entrenchments and artillery positions. I guess if we leave, let's test it out if we have a strong building crew if stuff happens. Ah, I didn't see the button here. Yeah, there's a good camouflaged hammer. So you can build trenches and I guess escalate into more and more sophisticated siege fortifications. Days. Okay, that makes sense. So they have half a year, they have supplies. Okay, capture another trading fleet. I can't see what this screen is about. Some of our buildings finished. Okay. You can dismiss it like in total war with right click. I like the siege screen, it's quite good work. You know, some of the sieges they took, I don't know, months, several months, and I mean, we could assault it, I mean, about 1,500 men. Looks like we have a numerical superiority, but in a siege, even 100 men can, in a siege, I don't know, hold off and a way bigger army. It's if they are fortified and supplied. Yeah, we can get closer and closer with the trenches. Might enable us to do engineer stuff, perhaps blow up the walls or whatever. Or we can build artillery positions. Can we build both? Yes, but I guess it will take twice the time. You see the bars are moving extremely slow. And they don't like it. Looks like building, we need to exchange the building crew. You see the morale is dropping extremely. It could be because of the siege and you see people are dying. Is it only the morale? Because it's the bar is representing the morale. Ah, strength, 124 of 200. So a lot of them already were killed by the siege. Yeah, siege is really, sieges, I mean, historical sieges are tedious and really costing affair. But we will continue it, not because we think it's the best choice. However, if a direct assault wouldn't be the best choice either. But because because he is placed here, I get it. Yeah, we might need troops. I guess this is the front line. Not sure if they also have a function. Yeah, they have a function. I guess they are exchanging fire on the distance. And that's also why their morale is reduced. Yeah, let's pause and think about it. I mean, the cavalry calf is basically useless in this. Are they sitting in the trenches right now? Okay. Let's put the horses in the trenches. But of course they can also dismount. Calf troops also folked often dismounted. You can see the assigned duties with this gray symbols here. So let's assign every infantry unit. This guy is already assigned somewhere else. Well, because artillery, I don't want to assign artillery to. They should. I mean, we could do it. I don't see the. Perhaps we can't do it. But this guy's. They are. They should fire. Yeah, and you can also put the calf, it looks like, into the position, which makes sense. At least I can't see. No, that's fine. Let's keep it this way and... Oh, so something happened. Somebody disappeared. Yeah, whatever. But looks like you have to consider your siege as good. Check the supply situation. That's of them. Ours is fine. Morale is an issue. They lost not a single man yet. Something happened. Yeah, the artillery got into position. And I guess they will not fire back. Yeah, they're receiving casualties. Which I guess represented by the symbol here. Okay, yeah, we can build here stuff. Trenches left flank, so the, it looks like there's some consideration which flank you want to use. Cover position, yeah, you, somebody, the grenadiers get into this position. These guys, for some reason, don't want to. Morale 13%, yeah, nope, they refuse to fight. Yeah, I'm interested to see what happens if we manage to access the walls. How you replenish lost troops? Yeah, is this a good question? Sure, if they sent, if they were, let's see if the numbers might rise again. But I guess you need to bring them back to the homeland or something. Not sure if there is some manpower replenishment received when in hostile territory, like in Paradox games. They aren't happy. I mean, what's going on? You're sieging. Must be a great life to be sitting in a goddamn trench being fired all day. Because some king decided it's no war. Okay, can we bring something else? Is there on the British mainland? First division, second division. Could you guys are sitting. I mean, an invasion of the British mainland isn't really... Holy shit, is this really the fastest way or what? Okay, yeah, well, this will take a lot of time, but... Okay, 3rd Division is sitting in... Yeah. I like this request function. I guess they're requesting the fleets. Yeah. This will take years, but okay. I like this function that they're requesting years fleet. So these guys sitting in North America, that's fine. Stay here. I mean, sure, we could charge, but another trading fleet captured by us, right? Not by them. Definitely bears. He's firing back. Are you kidding me? Trading ship 3-2-1. Does this mean 3-2-1 personnel or what? I mean, wait a second. If he's looking for trouble. Are these also friendships? Yeah, we need to keep the supplies and an eye on the supplies for the ships. Yeah. I think we will manage it. Can't believe that the Grand British Fleet will get defeated by a goddamn trading fleet. Okay, let's see how the siege is going. But I like this game. I mean, it has a realistic pace. You know, you can't, I don't know, capture 1 million towns and hilly-billy over the map. Warfare takes time, and especially the logistical effort will slow you down. I like it. And you know, in a real gameplay situation, we of course would plan the attack better. I might bring all my divisions quicker into play in order to surprise the French. Negotiating, what's going on? Both are so quiet. Oh, they disappeared. Okay, looks like these guys are done for good. So let's trigger them. What the hell? Yeah, you need some to go closer to being able to select them. So selection. Okay, they are now moving. But it looks like a complete game. I mean, I can tell from the, it isn't some completely, we like it, didn't expect it. Could imagine there are a lot of, oh. This bar doesn't look good for us. Yeah, let's press the autos. Siege button. Are you kidding me? Are you building everything in the same time? Does this even make sense? Yeah, I've activated the auto siege and now he's building like crazy. Man, this is slowing it down. I mean, sure, they will give up. Perhaps. Oh, the morale is dropping. What's the supply situation? 140 days. Yeah, I think. That's fine. What's our supply situation? Looks better. Yeah, you see the AI is switching them according to them. Because otherwise I could imagine it gets some micromanaging, especially because of the morale. So we will leave it to the commander. Two guys are ready to attack. If they come out of the fort, we have two guys defending. That's okay. Two guys are watching the gate. But I guess it's also automatic. So the AI will react to it. Yeah, the morale is dropping. People aren't happy in Lille. It looks like he's rebuilding everything at the same time. It might work out. Okay, let's check our fleets. Did he make any progress? Oh, he's already here. Not bad. But why is the guy... What's your problem? Is he out of supply? What is it? Is he drinking tea or what? He's finished. And let's take a look at the other army. Can't locate them. Trading fleet captured, I guess, for us. This is other division I've ordered in Northern Britain. Are they already on the ships? Here. Are they still moving? They will soon be here. This guy is, I guess, they are embarked now. Yeah. I mean, let's surprise them. and capture a harbor for us. I want a harbor town. Could go for Le Havre or Brest. But do we want to... I think don't go for two front war. Let's try to capture Paris as fast as possible in order to establish a new world order, which I won't do in this video. But I think the tutorial gives you a good idea to play it. And now I have an idea. I mean, this production elfing, sure, I don't know it in the detail, but I think it's also one of those games where stuff is running, and if it's running, keep it running. And you have some AI helps, that's also good. And that's fine by me. I think you can, it's quite a decent game. Okay, what's going on here? Are you making progress? Looks so. Morale 20, 70, 60. They must give up soon. Do we want to assault? No, not yet. Oh. They gave up. That's our new town. Yeah, hotkeys for the time would be extremely important. Okay. Now let's see, are they somehow resupplying? We'll speed up and see if it changed the numbers. No, they're even dying. Okay, I guess is it because I guess because they are still engaged with you know, duties, security duties, and there's still French that aren't happy about the new British government, who might have an argument with us. Yeah, they don't like the English language. This is really realistic. This is really good made. I think we need to do something at Lille. People are not happy there. Yeah, and I think this introduction made a good job. I mean, there's still some stuff you see me I need to figure out, but I guess the manual or some of the tutorial videos will help me to do this. Like, for example, garrison duties and... But you have an idea if you're at war with somebody and who you could wage war and trade war and naval warfare. And but yeah, one thing we need to check out, we might not be able to hear, but yeah, save the game. We will of course want to check out the tactical layer. Completely I forgot about it. And let's simply select a historical battle for it. Let's find something big. They're all quite big. Historical losses. Okay, this guy's got... Yeah, since this was a brutal battle. For both. And this are the battle pack for the DLC. So if you're doing historical battles, get this here. Okay. Ah, I guess this button decides which faction we will go with. Okay. Yeah, my microphone is working sometimes. No, I'm at Christmas. Yeah, together with the family, sometimes I need to attend stuff. Okay. Looks. Yeah, it's sprite-based, like Scourge of War. The camera is a bit interesting. Okay. You can save view positions for hotspots. Okay, is there a group? Or what is this? Let's check out all buttons. Small map. Okay, it's a mini map. Quite helpful. Casualties. Gives you an overview of the state of battle news. Okay. Retreat or quit. And I guess it's some sort of orders hierarchy. Yeah, we currently selected, I guess, can select individual units. There's an order of battle and hierarchy going on, but you can also select the complete division or whatever. I guess it's divisional information. Brigade, division, yeah. So we have three divisions, and I like it that you can group move like this. You know, I don't like micromanagement. And orders we have, sure, you can, I guess, reorganize hierarchies. Not sure if you can do it in battle, but normally you wouldn't like do something like this. It would be, no, it would be too complicated and take too much time. Group orders, fast march, melee. Build barricades. Okay, this looks like, not sure if it's only battle music. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it. Oh. Now I pressed the double. I was thinking it disable it. Now we hear it two times. So you can give the enemy 10 times advance. Yeah, it's you might advance a limited tile of paces. You know. Especially if you're near to the enemy, you can use this button. But can we cancel it? Yes, we can. So I'm not sure, can we move them? Not really. Is it already running the game? I mean, it's play. Is the time moving? 40, I think the time is, yeah, the time is, it looks like we're already in battle, so let's move out. You wait until the Zentrum rechts. Yeah, but you might turn. Can you turn? Yeah, it's like in Total War. Hold the right mouse button and release it. And you have an order delay, I think, which is displayed by the clock. I like it. And they will turn in time. They are talking currently in what every tactic game should have, the order delay or the let's speed it up. I can't tell. The camera is moving fluidly. I'm not sure if it's because of the sprites, but like I said, this could be the option. Let's see this update option. It looks, the units look a bit laggy, but the game itself isn't that laggy. How can I get rid of the screen? I guess this here. I could imagine this is this update function. Not sure if you can exit it. Topographic information is only available in DLC. Yeah, I will manage without it. Where is this option screen? Can't we access it from here? Don't think so. There was this battle updates. I could imagine this battle updates is and you guys get out of your sitting together. Maybe we could keep one as reserve. But I want to wait until all... what the hell? What a smoke, what did you do? Stop plundering the poor people here. I don't know what there is, some goddamn savages started a fire in the town. Ah, you mean the battle music, yeah, I really like it too. These guys don't have music options. No, wait, don't move out that far. But okay, yeah, whatever floats your boat. Looks like it. They don't stay in formation. If you give them too far orders, can I give them an order here? Yeah, that looks better, but it's wrong direction, I guess. I need to delete the orders, not sure what's button, but let's press this button and... Yeah, you will advance towards here. And looks like this is hostile territory. Okay. Yeah, they now need time to understand what's going on. And it's different for the units. So plan, don't make it too complicated and give them little movement orders. Okay, let's wait until they get into position. See how the advance works. can also work with the advance button. We'll keep them as reserve. And you see they move in an orderly fashion, simply a little some paces into the front, like. But I really like it. It gives me a Scorch of War feeling. Oh, enemy contact. Let's move out of the woods and engage them. They are not in firing range yet. Let's move more forward. Let's play some music. Just to announce our arrival. Okay, I think last one advance and then they should commit to the battle. Let's turn it back to real time. And yeah, you protect the road and on the left flank. And you advance in an orderly fashion towards this position. I like this superior command this game offers you. Okay, perhaps this way. And you advance also towards the north. Really like it. Really well made. Better, I mean, gives you better formation control than Total War. Okay. Are you firing? Do I need to commence for you? Guys, what's good? Oh, okay. Whoa. I think you saw the projector is. Let's move into this. Okay. Oh, what they are doing. Oh. Looks like they were trying to attack them, but now they are. Okay, looks like melee battle is commencing here. Do I need to give them a melee order? Or do we do... Hey guys, I think for your muskets, it's over. Is this a melee symbol? I guess so. Yeah, charge. I like the projector, it's looking. Oh. Okay, sound angry. Advance. Oh, wait, I have a single unit selected. Where's the division? This unit. No, they received the order. Okay. In order to close. In order to relieve the center or the, what is this unit, the, that's a division leader, center left center. I can imagine that this one graphic option makes the sprites more fluid, but I can't access the menu right now to check it out. We will do it before we finish the video. looks like the enemy cav. It's also red blinking, I guess there's some sort of wavering. Wasn't the best plan to come here. And the others are still advancing over the battlefield. These guys are behind our lines, that's not something, not the best we want to have, but I don't think they are combat efficient. Can't tell by the red flag, I guess the red flag is a representation of morale or whatever. I mean, you get an idea how it looks like. It looks a bit rough. It reminds me of a mix, I don't know, between Total War and Scourge of War. And sure, the combat animations aren't that high fidelity. And also, you could question the AI, why he is so committed to this Kev charge here, stuff like in Total War. I'm still impressed by which AI, Grand Battlefield AI or what you want to call it, impressed me somewhat, but I guess they also have some scripts running as the Scourge of War. At least the Gettysburg one, so really enjoyed the AI, because of the big troop sizes, you even are encouraged to use the AI in order to support you. What's going on with you? What's your problem? Did the commander die, or why are you wavering? Hey, stop! What's going on? They're trying to retreat, or what? Why? Because I guess they lost somebody. You get an idea how it works. I won't play it out, but if you're into historical battles and want to... What's going on with these guys? They are stuck, I guess, in the ground. Looks a bit like a marsh or whatever, slowing them down. Yeah, so what is strange, you can't move into the camera into two directions at the same time. Yeah. Okay, it's basically like Super Nintendo analog camera controls, but that's fine. I can work with it. Yeah, what I want to check out is you can return to the main menu, battle can be resumed, so it can be saved. And what I want to check out if this battle unit updates is impacting the animations. I mean, it's fine, I can work with it, and I know a lot of you also are fine, we don't need the... But sure, if there would be more fluid, I mean, I wouldn't say no. Yeah, it's really Total War, I don't know, it's... I mean, sometimes I even have the impression that there might be influence because Medieval I enjoyed, but after Empire, you could notice that the AI wasn't up to the musket warfare. And there's even some indications that they still use the AI engine from Total War 1. And modders tried everything to improve it. I think Medieval 2 makes some decent job. Sure, you always have this general suicidals and people running one by one, formations running into your army. Okay, is this enemy? Is this friendly? Friendly. Sächsische Brigade, okay, Saxons. And the same for the naval battlefields. The graphics always look beautiful, the detail beautiful, but AI, unit management, formation control, it is simply, it's unbelievable. It doesn't improve, or improves minimal, and sometimes I even have the feeling, like I said, from when they transitioned from Medieval 2 to this new engine, which I guess got introduced with Empire Total War, and could imagine it's still in use, what they created with Empire and the AI. Also the physics, something changed. In Medieval, when two armies clash, you can feel that there's weight behind it. You know, they clash together and they press each other away. And from Empire, I didn't play every Total War. I didn't play, what's it called, Warhammer. I think it looks great, but not the biggest Warhammer fan. And I didn't play, but I played this, you know, Napoleon, Empires, and whatever they had, the Britannia, or what. And if two armies clash there, it feels like scripted. They are somehow zoomed together. The two guys are glued together, you know, teleported together, and then they fight some, I don't know, Hollywood battle. You know, might have rose-tinted glasses because Rome Total War and Medieval Total War 2, I spent eons in it. Man, that's a big battle. But I remember Empires was for me a big letdown. And I tried so often to get into Total War and somehow never managed it too. And my new standard for this is, when it comes to tactical battles, is Scourge of War, Gettysburg, and what's the other, Waterloo. But if they don't have the best campaign layer, it's basically, I think Gettysburg resolves around single battles basically, and Waterloo has a dynamic campaign, but it's really rough. Really rough. Okay, they're already moving. Now let's take a look at the animations. Okay, let's see, somebody moving. It looks for me that, you see, it's more fluid now. Yeah, definitely. So if you, this option, battle updates or whatever, is basically, look at this, now it's really fluid. It's still sprite based. So they will of course suddenly turn because the sprites are represented in, I don't know what, 8 directions. It's basically 2D pictures. But you can tell by the movement, it's now on Scourge of War level. They are completely fluid, so get this. Not sure if it will hamper our performance, but currently I don't notice anything. There's a little lagging, but it's to be expected with games like this. Scourge of War also has this because, you know, I don't know how many people are now on the map, but you know, in Total War you have, I don't know what is a big battle there, 5,000, 10,000 guys. In games like this, or in games like Scourge of War, you might have 50,000. I think Gettysburg was what? I don't know, it's unbelievable how many people folk there. And you have every single dude sitting there in the game. So I think some lag is acceptable. And it really was impressive for me to fight Gettysburg, it's unbelievable. I mean, sure, you see it in documentaries, but if you play your own, this battle, give the orders. Is this a division? Yeah. Move out. Yeah, fine by me. Yeah, it's better to keep the right mouse button clicked, because otherwise you might end up with unexpected movement. The rotation of the movement, it's sometimes not, it's hard to predict. But I think I like this. I like this division-based movement. It isn't micromanaging heavy. Okay, these guys are you an artillery? What are you? Cav, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, hold. Yeah, you see, it's really a big battle. I mean, this corps has 10,000 people. This division alone has 10,000. Only foot soldiers, 2,000 cav, 200 artillery or whatever. I mean, they don't look that much, but or is it perhaps I'm reading it wrong. I guess there's some abstraction going on. These aren't 2,000 guys. Are they? But I'm already impressed that the AI isn't charging you. And I don't know, charging you with artillery cards. That's all what I usually expect from Total War. However, Total War also has scripted battles in which you can notice that the AI behaves different, you know, if you enter some trigger area, they will respond and whatever. But I mean, the normal dynamic battles, siege battles and whatever, really really rough. Save time. Yeah, time compression is also working pretty fine for the troop amount we have here. And you see the sprites are now completely fluid. So this is the setting. What are you doing? Don't make it complicated, make it easy. The effects aren't that sophisticated like in Scorch of War, but I think it's still fine. Let's see how this plays out. This will end up in a big line battle. Already here, looks like they got historical sounds. I mean, what the hell? No! Not my artillery! Holy shit. Yeah, okay, the animations are rough, but it's, for me, it still works, I'm fine with it. I didn't expect this, I must say I'm impressed, I didn't expect this. What the hell is happening here? Perhaps it's too aggressive. Perhaps you want to stop. Whatever. If you play it serious, you know, put some consideration into it. Make careful moves. It's like in Scorch of War. It's better to make little moves than big moves. Because it might throw off your formations. And graphic fidelity, I guess you can run reshade on it, it might be, it will be DirectX 9 or whatever, I expect. In order to get your, I don't know, custom graphics quality. Yeah, come on, retreat. Leave my artillery on, oh no, that's, looks like they got our artillery guy. Yeah, you can see reloading them. Looks a bit blurred, everything, hard to tell, and the projectors look like some big, I don't know, pigeons, but that's fine. this game also has this issue, like what I mentioned before, and there's sometimes no real mass behind the individuals, be it cav or be it infantry. Sometimes they move through your formations and end up behind you, and you are asking yourself, how the hell did this happen? And yeah, it looks a bit chaotic, not only in a battle sense, but also in the animation or how the battles resolve, it looks chaotic. I mean, this looks fine. You know, you get a sense of they are pressed and being pressed. It's a really huge battle. Normally it's not good to have a disconnected flank like we have here, you know, there's nothing here. I mean, sure, we have, because we didn't touch this element yet. We can do, you know, I don't play serious right now, I just want to check out the tactical layer. But also in order to enjoy this game more, it's the same for Scorch of War. Try to keep always some historical way of play or procedures in mind. What? 41 killed of them. 0 by us. Okay, not bad. Yeah, it's similar to Medieval Total War 1, where they had exactly. And it also reminds me of Scourge of War. It's also sprite-based, and in Scourge of War it must be sprite-based, because you have, I think, you know, Gettysburg, what was the historical order of Battle of Gettysburg? How many people, and you couldn't play this battle with every dude being a 3D guy. I mean, I tried some stuff in Total War games, and you can, you know, if you put too much troops into the editor, you see that the game engine completely fails. Medieval 1 is on sale, okay. Yeah, no, there are still people who play it. For me, my two most impressive or most exciting Total War titles are Rome Total War, Rome 1, and Medieval 2 Total War with Kingdoms. I own Napoleon, I own Empires, I own Rome 2. I've tried to get the best mods, and I really admire what modders achieved, even with these games. Never got into them. Even found myself to install these two games again in order to play the biggest mod projects, like, I don't know, Europa Barbarorum, or Third Age. It's a fantasy, Lord of the Rings mod, but it's still not bad. I have a GeForce, I think 1600 or something. GTX 1600 or something. Yeah, it's sometimes really crazy. I mean, during this Steam sales, I mean, kind of understand it. It might put a lot of pressure on the devs or publishers, but it's something sometimes really crazy. If you think about it, that this costs as much, not even as much as in coffee, what we are playing here. I mean, €2. That's a medium coffee, perhaps not even a little coffee, small coffee. Yeah, I've tried to get into them. I've really, especially Rome 2, I was awaiting it. And I remember seeing the first battle and I was thinking, I don't know, it's especially this, you know, if the enemy, how they move, the movement, the animation, it looks, all looks so artificial. And if you know, in Rome 1 and in Medieval, when two armies connect, I always zoomed into it and waited for this moment, you know, when two calf charges and they charge into each other. Sure, it was over the top. Sometimes you even saw people flying into the air, but you really noticed there's some physics going on behind it. And in the new games, it feels like, you know, you have this connect-disconnect feeling. There's some script, I don't know, formation 1 connect with formation 2, and then you see this fighting animation, but it feels all like, you know, eye candy, but not really stuff happening. And also the movement, it's sometimes they move extremely fast. I know there are mods that try to make it more realistic again, but I don't know. And the sieges, and never found into them. I mean, the campaign layer is also the same. They changed, I think with Rome Total War 2, they changed to the 3D portrays. I couldn't tell the dudes apart. I couldn't tell when who is my imperator, who is my general. They all looked like the same, you know, uncanny valley effect. They all looked like the same puppet. And also, I mean, there were interesting stuff like political stuff, but for this they removed, I don't know, a lot of this crazy traits from Medieval Total War 2 and Rome Total War, you know, and Drunkard or whatever, which gave you some personality. You know, if you had some general that fought 20 battles, man, he was basically a PTSD dude sitting in the, you couldn't leave him too long in the inner city, otherwise he would become a complete drunkard and visit every border. I enjoyed really stuff like this. But it could also be because I talked about rose-tinted glasses. I mean, every Total War game is somewhere similar for the last, I don't know, 10, 15 years. It's basically the same system. And I can understand if people say, if you play it one, you play it not to some degree, you play it all of them. And, you know, I played these two titles extremely, and it could be also that I'm fatigued to play this Total War system, and I might perceive the newer games as less quality. But I'm not alone with it, I know it. And also, if you check the modding communities, the modding community for Medieval 2 and Rome Total, even for Rome Total War, is still going crazy. Yeah, and I own Attila Total War. There was also a mod released for it, Forgotten King, Empire, something with Empires, about Rome, but I also didn't got into it. The AI made a better impression in this mod. I remember seeing a footage on YouTube where I finally saw a formation that AI formation that somehow stick together without sending single, I don't know, archer units into, or single generals into your spearhead, but I'm not sure, I didn't get somehow into it. Yeah, that's also my opinion. Rome 1 and Medieval 2 are also for me the best games, and it's not that I didn't try to get into the others. I waited on Empires. I remember back then I was quite young, Empires, when I heard about, when I saw the footage on the naval warfare, and I mean, you can boot up Empire's Total Warfare, get into the naval warfare, you will think it's still looking fantastic. I mean, this, the visuals of the crew, and it's still on another level. And this game is what, 10 years old or what? I can't remember. And but yeah, it's a lot of eye candy. But under the hood, I remember the first battles with the natives or whatever. And I've noticed the AI moving forward, moving back, moving forward, moving back, 2 meters in front of your muskets. And I was realizing, oh shit, this won't be the dream game I was thinking. And these two games, yeah, and I also like the 2D portraits more. I'm not some retro guy, but 3D faces. There are not many games that get 3D faces, especially these generated faces. Quite good. I like the faces of, yeah, Rome Total War. Crusader Kings also has a good face generator. If there's a dude I don't like, I can tell him even after 2 hours. But in Rome Total War, I couldn't tell my in Rome Total War 2, I couldn't tell anybody apart because they all looked like the same generic dude or generic woman. And I get it. I mean, I guess it's also an intent of Total War. They moved to a more action-based experience. I could imagine being more in line with what the modern crowd is looking for. I'm not sure, but I also know that a lot of people. I often think publishers force also some stuff on you. I never heard about it that Rome or Medieval was too complicated for people. It's exactly the opposite was the case. Everybody loved the battles. Sure, there were some mods that made the battles extreme long, because really Medieval battles, they took hours, or even people fought each other being completely fatigued, couldn't even raise the sword anymore. And there are some stuff that was even too much for me, I'm not sure, stainless steel or other mods that made it extremely hardcore. And there was also the supply system, where you also had a supply mod basically into the game, what was it called, not sure, for Medieval 2, and of course it then resulted. But I think the vanilla mode Medieval Total War was even time efficient. Yeah, our lines look pretty good. I'm not sure what this is here. This is shown here. Did they stop? Are they still trying to move into this direction? Oh, okay, yeah. And yeah, but the enemy organization, at least you don't have this. It looks like they aren't, of course. The organization of them is terrible. But at least they somehow stick together and I don't know, you have a single formation here, then some dude with his artillery cart is charging into your elite calf. Some suicide bomber. Yeah, Total War, man. The suicide bombers. I mean, to be honest, at least from this battle, it doesn't look like that this is, I don't know, the half 3000 AI, but yeah. At least they stick together. I mean, that's. And on the right flank, they pretty much destroyed us and move also in some, you see here, look at this, they move in a cohesive fashion. This never would happen in Total War. I don't do this. And look at this. They are coming with music, with a music pack. They only waited for us to make fun of them, and now they will charge through our center. So, yeah, still better than TW. You know, TW always said this. I tried so many AI mods. People moving here, moving back, moving here, moving back while you're shooting them. It's never fixed. I don't know for. They had 3, 4, 5 games with muskets, moving forward, moving back, moving forward, moving back. Because I don't know what was going on, but I've read about it that they have some hard-coded AI engine or whatever, and in order to fix the AI, they would have need to reprogram the engine or whatever. And you know, this AI modding, which is done for Total War, it's working on a script level. It's not working on an engine level. It's basically a text script which is telling the AI engine what to do or in what situation. But the AI and its behavior itself is somewhere built in the engine, which is not accessible, at least after my interpretation. And look at this, they can maintain a line here. Sure, they sometimes adjust, but at least you have a line battle here, and that's almost impossible in Empire Total War or something like this. Yeah, interesting formation, but yeah, of course, the Assassins sometimes do move too much. I don't know what they are now doing. It's getting some crazy formation going on. Yeah, it won't intervene. This is not made for giving you some grand tactician, grand general look how I will race them. But I simply want to let it play, see how the AI behaves. It gives me an idea of the limitations and possibilities. But this music crew here, this Ghetto Blaster crew, when they are breaking through our center right now, look at this. That's the counterattack. Look at this, their music tunes are eating us. Looks like some infestation. Man, the Grenadiers. Yeah, I mean, you know what is funny in Total War? I mean, there's also this joke where a cat is playing Total War and there's a screen. In Total War, when you finish a battle, you get a screen. It shows, I don't know, major victory. It shows major victory, minor victory, you know, and there's this menu. What? What the hell? The music crew, what happened? Looks like they killed our general or whatever. Yeah, you see? Never underestimate the poisons if they have some good tracks with them. Yeah, we lost. Please enter name for rank. I am impressed. And yeah, fine. I mean, it has issues, you can tell. Obviously, it has issues. It's difficult to make a game, especially in a musket time, you know, where you need to consider always a formation. It's not like Command Conquer, sending a bunch of tanks into the enemy. And I know what the challenge is for getting AI done, because formation, facing, distance is extremely important, and it's hard to tell a blind AI when to do what. But it looks functional, it doesn't look dysfunctional. Like, I don't know, I wanted to complete this joke with a cat is sitting there, and when you finish a Total War battle, you get a screen, I don't know, heroic victory, and there was a screen, a meme screen, where a cat is sitting on the screen, simply, I don't know, with his pressing buttons, and then there is a screen, heroic victory, which means that you can even let play on. There's even, I think, the joke that somebody is AFK, he returns, and on his screen is heroic victory. Because the AI is sometimes so incapable, you can leave your formation sitting there, start the battle, go, I don't know, see your friends, get a drink, return, and you will see a heroic victory, because the AI is simply, I don't know, suiciding single units into your formation, and you don't need to do much. And you see, here we faced a defeat because we didn't do anything. We should have reacted to the center, and I guess it killed perhaps a superior or even the general. And in a battle back then, it was re-centralized around generals and officers. If they were killed, you know, these people, they weren't fighting there for patriotism or whatever. They were fighting because they were forced to. And if the superior fell, a battle could turn into in minutes. in minutes, a medical term, if something like this happened. And it has issues, but it's functional. You can do some stuff. Sure, they will do silly stuff like, I don't know, facing you in a wrong facing, but yeah. Yeah, they lost more, but in the end, they prevailed. You have great statistics. But of course, this is a scripted battle. These historical battles, they often come with special scripts. For a complete overview of the AI capabilities, we of course would have to do a dynamic campaign on the campaign map. Because then you can really tell how the AI operates in this game, because this, you know, often comes with specific scripts, because it's a predetermined battle. Yeah, that's... I'm impressed without a name. Okay, I think that's it. Campaign, historical battle, low bet options, and yeah, keep the setting in mind. Why is my game so... my sprites are lagging. Yeah, set this to high and you're good to go. Military focus. I guess this is for the AI to focus on military. What would be great would be some hotkeys for speeding up the game. And other than that, quite compelling game. Check it out if you into historical battles or into Swedish. Check out the further content. And I think I will now make a little break, and then I will make a video about Phantom Doctrine. And yeah, see you in, I don't know, 15 minutes or something.